Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The Heifetz International Music Institute and its Festival of Concerts. More than 50 live concerts in Stanton, Virginia, and daily programs streaming worldwide. Full calendar and information at heifetzinstitute.org.
Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to our new Thursday night chamber music program. I'm not faculty chamber music showcase. The chamber music night here at the Heifetz International Music Institute. I'm Benjamin Rowe, the president and CEO of the Heifetz International Music Institute. Nicholas Kitchen, our artistic director. Great to see you all here in Francis Auditorium, and to those of you who are watching us online on Facebook Live or on our YouTube channel. Now, before we begin tonight with the serious business of some serious and wonderful chamber music, there is something going on in this auditorium tonight that has not happened all year. And I'm curious if anybody knows what that is. All right, Cliff. Here, you get a free raffle ticket. So this is a great irony. For those of you who were here last night, it was Mary Baldwin night. And we have been looking for that sign since last August. It just disappeared. And this morning, lo and behold, we had the sign laid out outside of the auditorium here with a little explanatory note from the very nice people at one of the science labs here at Pierce. It might have been a collegiate prank. That's my theory. But anyway, we have now reunited. This was not a political statement. We have now reunited Institute, Heifetz, and Mary Baldwin University. Let the record show. Now, of course, you see what I did there, Cliff. I also got a chance to work in the raffle ticket, you see, so. Which you can get at intermission, of course, for the drawing, our final drawing on Sunday. So be advised. Now, let's talk about the program, Nick.
Well, you know, we've mentioned a few times that I think I'm so happy that we're all getting to enjoy music that sometimes we don't get that many chances to hear. How many people have heard the Beaver Crucifixion Sonata? That's not a lot of people. I won't say too much more. It's actually done with a different tuning. I have a feeling that will be explained, what they call scordatura. And they're playing it absolutely beautifully. I'm so happy you're going to hear that, a wonderful piece of music. And of course, then we move on to these giants in the repertoire for chamber music, the G major viola quintet and the cello quintet of the G major viola quintet of Brahms. And the cello quintet of Schubert. I think we've said this a few times, but for quite a number of years, we thought, oh, it would be so nice to have faculty and students play together. And we've done that, of course, but what's always felt a little uncomfortable is that then it ends up that some students do it, but other students don't, and I'm not sure, it's always okay. But finally, we kind of were thinking and said, you know, every group can do this collaboration. So after tonight's concert, if you've been coming to all the concerts, you will have heard all 13 string quartets at the Heifetz Institute Senior Division play in collaboration with faculty. And we've had Mozart viola quintets, we've had Bach pieces, we've had all kinds of wonderful works of music, Mendelssohn Octet in a sort of a grand celebration of that piece. I'm just so happy that every single student that's in those groups is going to have had that experience of really working closely with these fabulous faculty members that they're working with in lessons and getting to know, but now they're going to share the stage together. And I can tell you, I've just watched each group, and it's just wonderful. They are developing their own projects about what they're going to work on, when they're going to work on intonation, and when they're going to work on their timing, when they're going to try a more adventurous timing. Whatever it is, this is the kind of process that is so exciting about chamber music, that the works are so rich and complex that we rediscover them constantly as we go deeper and deeper into them. And I'm just so thrilled that these great pieces have had exactly that experience between our students and our faculty. So hope you enjoy tonight's program. I know it's great music, great performances, great collaborations, and well, here we go.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Yuna Kim. I am 22 years old and I'm from the Bay Area, California. Joined with me is Benjamin Doan on basso continuo. This is our fourth summer attending summer festival, and Ben cannot escape me. I'm so happy to be playing with him, and you'll know exactly why when we perform today. We are really excited to play a piece by Bieber titled Rosary Sonata No. 10, Crucifixion. Now, this composer is not to be confused with the singer Justin Bieber. This Heinrich Bieber lived from 1644 to 1704. And he is most known for the Rosary Sonatas. They're some of the earliest known violin sonatas ever written. And there are 15 of them, plus an extra Passacaglia, but the 15 are divided into the Christian triptych. The first five sonatas represent the birth of Jesus Christ, and they're titled Joyful Mysteries. Sonata 6 through 10 are representative of the death and are titled the Sorrowful Mysteries. And sonatas 11 through 15 are the Resurrection, Glorious Mysteries. A common misconception I feel like some people have, and I myself had, about Baroque music is that it is to be treated really delicately and to be played gracefully. And while I still believe that to be true, studying this work and experiencing Bieber's crazy musical voice changed my mind. Baroque music has really become an opulent, grand art form. On a last note, literally, my E string is tuned to a D. Bieber uses scordatura in most of the Rosary Sonatas, and what that means is that the tuning is not the conventional standard tuning. Because of this, it already doesn't really sound like a violin. And finding this really dark timbre and exploring color has been really, really interesting. We're really excited to play this piece like a grotesque and visceral Baroque painting. Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Gia, and I'm joined on stage by Madeline, Charisse, and Peter. We're also joined by esteemed faculty member Nicholas Cords. Tonight, we'll be performing the first movement of String Quintet No. 2 in G major by Johannes Brahms. When Brahms composed this in 1890, he intended for it to be his final composition. It builds upon his first viola quintet, written 8 years before, and would have been the perfect final composition had he not been inspired during the summer of 1891 to compose chamber works featuring the clarinet, such as his clarinet sonatas. Like many of his compositions, this piece was originally conceived as a sketch for a symphony, utilizing the extra viola to evoke a grander symphonic scale in this movement. Brahms fills this piece with grand sweeping themes, contrasted with soft shimmering melodies and bold dynamic conversations between the instruments. We hope our performance tonight brings to life Brahms' vision for this quintet.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Sasha Lukashuk, and today my group members and I, Vincent, Esther, and Sachin, are joined by the wonderful professor and violist, Mr. Kortz. I just want to take a moment to thank Mr. Kortz for working on this magnificent piece with us this week and for bringing so much inspiration to each of us. Thank you. Today we are performing the second movement of the Viola Quintet in G major by Brahms. Just a few notes on this piece, this particular movement. In contrast to the first movement, the second movement brings this very inward character with a very dark and melancholic feel. It begins with a stately march brought by a duet with the two violas and over a pizzicato bass line in the cello. In the middle of the movement, a storm unleashes. And finally, at the end of the movement, we have the final statement of the march. I think that this is probably one of the best chamber works ever written. And so I'm very glad that my group and I have the opportunity to perform it for you tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Hoon Choi, and this is Haejin on the first violin, Willin on the second violin, and Melissa on the first viola, and Adrian on the second viola. We are Windhaven Quartet with Melissa. Tonight, we will be performing the last movement of String Quintet No. 2 by Johannes Brahms. Brahms was such a warm, sophisticated, and considerate person. So, when he write music, he always wanted to be impeccable. Also, when he was writing music, he usually got some idea and advice from people. And in the end, he said, "This piece is the last work in my life." We could kind of believe that because if you see its opus number, it is opus 111, which is the same opus number with Last Piano Sonata by Beethoven, who was musical hero of Brahms. Also, this piece premiered November 11th, 1890. Isn't it interesting? As a great musician, we never stop studying and exploring music. But of course, you know, Brahms composed more beautiful music in later his life. In this movement, we can feel Hungarian dance elements, which he loved to use in his many pieces. Also, he loved sound of viola and adored combination of two violas and one cello in the string quintet, like Mozart. Also, we can feel the beautiful melodic and rhythmic gesture that each instrument has. It was such a pleasure to work this beautiful music with Melissa, and I hope we can hear his sincere and profound voice through this piece. Thank you.
So something else happened today besides the reappearing signage that was really something truly wonderful. We had never done a Thursday, a midweek junior division showcase, and we did one today, and it was spectacular. Did not have a large crowd there, which I hope you all will rectify next Thursday when they do their next one. Really was a wonderful, if you haven't been there, our South Market stage is in the back of Grace Christian. For you old timers here in Stanton, that is the former public library here, actually. And when I walked in there a couple years ago, I was astonished to discover it also seats 435 people. So it's one reason why we have a very nice stage there, a great Baldwin piano, and the extraordinary talent level of the students in our junior division, and they really showed it today. So I do hope that you'll come and encourage them. They're doing two concerts this weekend at 11 a.m., a chamber music showcase, and then at 2, a solo showcase. The 11 a.m. program will have no intermission. It'll be very analogous to our Friday in the Gallery concert, only for the junior division. So we'll have the senior division playing chamber music, more chamber music, this Friday, tomorrow, at the Stanton Augusta Arts Center. We play right in the lower gallery there, and it's really great to be surrounded by all the artworks there, to be right downtown, very nice acoustics, and it's a really great intimate experience to explore these string quartets. And they have a wonderful program lined up tomorrow. The Grieg, the last movement of the Grieg string quartet, two movements of the Prokofiev second quartet, first movement of the Bartok quartet. Really is going to be quite a good program, so I hope you can join it there. Of course, in the evening, it'll be more chamber music with Sublime Sextets. One sextet, pretty well known here in the Heifetz stage, the Tchaikovsky Souvenir de Florence. One much less known, a really wonderful, interesting piece, the Bohuslav Martineau Sextet, which will also be featured in this Celebrity Series program. The happy hour is at 6:30, the concert at 7:30. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. But wait, there's more. We'll be at the Farmer's Market for a final time this Saturday. And also this Saturday, Boohoo will be the final Heifetz Hootenanny of the season. But it's going to be a great program, I guarantee you. Everybody's come out of the woodwork that wants to play in this one. So you really want to be there for that. And our final Sunday matinee of the season is going to be on Sunday. And there's a terrific program lined up for that as well. So we may be starting to count down, but still there are about a dozen concerts that remain in our season. So if you've just discovered Heifetz, there's lots more riches that await before we call 2023 history. So thank you all, and can't wait to hear this Schubert in the second half.
Good evening. My name is Cecilia Martin, and I'm here with my friends Jaire on the violin, William on the cello, and Carlos on the viola. And today we will be playing the first movement of the string quintet by Franz Schubert with the lovely Stephen Doan on second cello. This is actually the last chamber piece that Schubert ever wrote, and he died only 2 months after it was finished. And in my opinion, and in the opinion of many other musicians, it is one of the greatest chamber works ever written, and certainly one of the most fun to play. The first movement is the longest of the four movements, and it contains a lot of unexpected harmonic turns, tension, and gorgeous expansive melodies. We had a lot of fun putting this movement together and working with Professor Doan, and we're excited to celebrate this great piece with you all tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. are the Pamlico Quartet, joined with Professor Yi-Sun Kim. Tonight, we are playing the second movement of the cello quintet by Schubert. When we got the email that we would get to play this with Professor Kim, I was really, really excited because I'm a cellist and the Schubert Quintet is iconic. And so I've grown up, you know, sight reading it with a lot of friends. So it's lovely that we get to play it now. So the second movement brings on more of a peaceful feeling. It starts with a very wide, expansive chorale by a trio of the Inner Voices. And to me, it forms kind of an outdoor scene of a meadow. And we have our little bird chirping on the branch, our first violinist. And she's joined in a sweet dialogue with the second cello. And throughout this movement, you'll hear a conversation between her and the second cello until this rumbling thunder takes over and a big storm rolls in. And then the first cello takes over with the first violin singing a very dramatic operatic melody. And there's a lot of distress and grief and longing. It's very desperate. And all of a sudden it comes to a tense standstill and the sun slowly reemerges and we're back to our peaceful meadow. And the resolution of this movement is one of the most beautiful in all music. It's very still and very peaceful. And it's these moments in our lives that I value very strongly. When the storms are just rolling on, it's good when we can find a moment of peace. And so we're excited to share that with you tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening.
My name is
Aiden Garrison, and I'm joined on stage by my quartet, Noel, Maya, and Kareem, as well as Professor Rosemary Elliott. Tonight, we're going to present to you the final movement of the string quintet in C major by Franz Schubert. You might have already heard some of it tonight. So before I talk about the piece, I just want to thank Professor Elliott for working with us this week. We've all had such an amazing time. She's been such an inspiration, and we've just had so much fun with this piece. I also think you guys are going to have a lot of fun with it. It opens with this very boisterous, exuberant theme. It's based on Hungarian melodies. And then after a bit, we're going to get into this really gorgeous, sweet singing melodic line. It's very typical of Schubert's compositional style. One very exciting thing about this piece is it's so boisterous that our first violinist actually broke a string warming up. So we've been having a lot of fun with this, and we hope you have fun listening to it. Thank you.